Hello guys, here we are. Take a look at that.
Two wolves. Wolf.
Come, wolf. Come, wolf.
A wolf. 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 Wolf.
What a big boy.
Wolf. Wolf.
Oh, he gives me his hand. Okay, I have to leave the camera. I'm going to play with him. And here we are. Outside, it's a bit cold, shall I say. This doesn't matter for Buddy or Wolf. And the best way to spend one afternoon is to be with these furry little friends, these furry friends, and one model ship to build. Buddy, are you agree? Do you agree? Oh yeah, that's the spot. Yeah. That's the spot. A dog. Buddy. Okay, buddy. Get off me. You do not fit over there. So, let's see now. We have done a lot of work in the previous video, and now it is time to finish some more pieces, like I see here the platforms that I have skipped. They must be done. Also the supports over here, the other supports over there, and the exterior steps. And of course I'm not going to pass any rings at the moment. This is, if I did, it would be a big mistake, because we're going to have to varnish the ship. So if I pass the rings at the moment, the rings are going to be filled up with the varnish. And I'm missing the rope for the bell. Again, this is going to be passed after the varnishing. So, we have to do all that, and then we're going to do my favorite part, the stern, which requires painting. So, let me get the camera tripod and we will begin. Alright, these are the materials that we're going to need for making the platforms. This is 2x10. It's African walnut, and we're going to use to cut the platforms and fold them for the side. Also, we need some supports for the platforms. We need 12 of them. Here they are, 10 plus 2, 12. These are prefixed. They have to be separated, of course. So, let me cut the platforms in the appropriate size, because this will take some time. Separate the supports from the rest of the laser cut board, and I'll get back to you to continue. All right, I have separated the pieces. They are two of each size, of course, three platforms. Of course, I don't understand why we have three platforms with two masts, but okay. Probably one mast must have two. I like to make the outside of the platforms round up. So this is very easy. Very easy and very fast. Got it. Let me do the other four and I'll get back to you. All right, now what we need to do now is see where to open the holes. We have to mark the holes. This is the beauty with that type of platforms. They're more beautiful, but you have to open up the holes. So this is the piece over here. As you can see, the holes are open up around over here. So here's one, here's another. I will make sure that they are in straight line. And I have to make a small mark over here. I need something pointy. All right, this is ready to be drilled. What you have to be very careful with is that one platform is like this. The other is the opposite. It's not exactly like this. If you take this one, logically, it won't fit. For some odd reason, this one fits. Usually, the platform of this side does not fit exactly the other side. You have to turn it around. But I can see that this one is fits completely. So, okay. Let's make the small one. That's odd. Never saw that. Yeah, this one fits also. Strange. Now for this one, of course you understand that because there's the half over here, we'll do half over this drawing and the other half on the other. I'm going to use again these drawings so I can place the platforms on the ship, of course. I have three, not drilled yet. I have to mark the other three the same way. Let me check. I am seeing the picture. There are six dead eyes on this one. So I have six. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 on this one. I have 5 and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 here. Okay, correct. Let me do the rest. Now I have to drill the holes. It says to open up holes at 1 millimeter diameter. I'm going to go with 1.5 because it's better to have a little bit more. All right, let's place the platforms. These pieces were glued wrong. If you go back to the video, you will see that I have glued them all the way down here. It was wrong, so I have to lift them up over there. This is the correct position. Now, let's see where to glue and how to glue. We have the big platform. The big platform goes, as I can see from the photos, over there, to the height of over here, to this height, so like this. And as I can see, I have to use these two pieces. Let's make it more visible over there, so you can see in the lower corner. And I have to put them in between here. So let's do a test run. All right, let's glue this one and see how it goes. This is helping with the height. And the other one. And now you can see that here we have an angle upwards, so of course it's not going to follow the angle, it's going to be straight. So I have to put it over here like that. Let's make sure that we have a flat surface.
So, let me glue the platforms on the other side and I'll get back to you.
Alright now, we have some work to do here with 2mm wood strips. These are the wood strips, the African walnut, 2mm. We have to place 4 of them and 4 parts on the top, but I will worry about the top later. The 2 are going to end over here. So, let's put them all ready. But I have to finish them on the top of the rail. So, let's measure. So, one will go like this, but I have to form a little bit at the end. I have, as you can see here, don't know if it's visible, I have a very small gap over here. So I have to cut a little piece from behind to make it fit. Let me do that, it's very easy. And it won't take long. All right, I had it open for the first, of course, and I don't believe it's visible from there, but underneath, over here, I have a big gap, because the hull is like that. So what I have to do is bend this wood strip slightly on the from the outside to the inside, so that it will be able to follow the hull. It's pretty easy to do that, but it will take some time because I'll be waiting for the soldering iron to reach the temperature that I need. Let me cut the piece. Have it. And also let me form the upper side exactly as before. I need a slight bend to the inside, like that. It's going to be perfect. I believe here I'm going to need some wood putty later on to cover up these gaps. Or not. The piece is not ready to be glued yet. Let me bend it and I'll get back to you. Now the piece is ready. As you can see, it's slightly bended. Before gluing it, I have to form the lower part. I have to make it round. Ready. I have to do exactly the same on the side. We have to place two. Let me do that and I'll get back to you to continue on the top. All right. I have the gaps filled with 0.5. It's better than wood putty, so it looks more beautiful. Also, when the varnish is applied, everything will be perfect. Needs a little sanding over here, but that I will do later. Now, over to the top, we have to put 4 pieces. Make sure that the pieces are a little bit exceeded over the edge of each of these, let's say, pillars. Let's call them pillars. Mark where to cut. I will do one with you and the rest on my own. Of course, I have to do the other side as well. And I'll get back to you to do the steps. The exterior ladder. Around. Over here. You won't be able to see it, of course, because I'm going to sand it. Let me do that and I'll show you the finishing. You can see the piece is rounded up inside and out. Now, let me do them all because this will take a while and I'll get back to you. The other side is done as well. Now we're going to do the outside ladder. We're going to need pieces 2x2 and 1x4. This is 2x4. I need 1x4. I will find it somehow over there in the pile. Let me cut them in the corresponding length and I'll get back to you. Now, we're going to make the steps, the exterior ladder. For the steps, the instructions tell me to use 2x2 African walnut and 1x4 African walnut, which does not exist in the box, but no problem, I will use sepally because I like sepally. I have African walnut, but since this model has no sepally on up to this point and also in the wood supply, I will use some sepally over here the wood steps. I like it. So I have cut them in the size that I need and now I have to glue them. To glue them, I have to use 6 steps on each side, if I'm not mistaken. I have here the photos. I have to put the steps over here. Now, this is not very hard, just I have to do it right. The first step that goes is the sepally one for my case. Sorry for that, guys, the camera is just in the way. And underneath I'm going to put a 2x2 piece. also some glue here. Now let's see where the second one goes. The second one and finally the big piece that must go here in the middle. Okay, the ladder is complete. I will do the other one and I'll get back to you to show you the finishing result and end this video. And here we are. Finished. Beautiful made. Both sides, of course. This is the second side. So, we have placed everything on the side. These pieces, a little bit hard, the exterior ladders, the platforms, everything. So the next step is going to be the stern. We have to paint the piece, and I can see we have to paint some over to the ship side as well. We have to make the officers' quarters. It's not going to be a very hard job, but definitely it will require some attention. So I hope to see you all to our next step. Thank you very much for watching. Don't forget the Super Thanks ability, and I hope to see your next step, because with our next step this ship will be transformed into an extreme beauty. Also with the place of the stern, I will be able to place the ladder and do a test run. Thank you very much, guys. Take care.